Point you said that education is not about our regional educational system. I don't agree with that. Most importantly, for this panel, we are here to discuss our practical daily life. So we will deal with our educational system, what we are going through. So yes, you said that training directly without getting the proper education. Yes, I would like to say that that is a better option. If the society forces you to get a degree,
sorry for interruption, but just one question. We are here talking about the basic companies like Infosys or Cognizant, right? So would you be able to work for companies like Microsoft, Google or Facebook without being educated with that training period of 1 month? Would you be, and let me add another thing to it. Let's say, let's just suppose all of us that education does not help us with being successful. Let's just say, so why education? Why do we have to study all those subjects that are totally irrelevant? Because maybe we'll find something new out of it. You know, maybe that is the only way how we can find the feel of our interest. Suppose, okay, you are an IT guy, right? You like computers. You were never sent to school. You were never educated. You were never told about computers. Would you be able to make it? Let's not even talk about you, a hundred
professional education, please.
Certainly, obviously, that's why we are here, right?
We're talking about college education.
College education, bhai.
I would like to ask one question from you. Let's focus on our recent issue that's going on in India, the JNU. The people are not educated. I'm asking you.
Actually, you are deviating from the topic a bit. The topic is education and success. Is there a correlation? See, I would like to give some of the inputs that you could work upon. Is education necessary for a man or person to be successful? Right? And is there a correlation between them? Right? See, there was a slide on this screen that said, Albert Einstein said that education is hindering my progress. Imagination could made me successful, made me the man who I am right now. My imaginative powers. He said that education won't be that necessary. But again, there are many who say that education is the key to success, right? And I would like you all to speak from your daily experiences. What you are experiencing right now? You are all being educated over here. Does that guarantee you success? A person who is not being educated, or is I would like to give an example, like the founder of Alibaba. He applied for many jobs. He wasn't qualified for that job, but he applied for many jobs. And at last he created the Alibaba.com. And you know what it is valued at, right? So these are my inputs. I would like you to be connected to the topic and speak accordingly, right? So.
You have given the example of the Google working for a Google. For a common man, working for a superior is never a definition of a success. You have given the example again of a worker, and we are here talking about successful persons.
Okay, we were on the placements thing, right? Any person, I mean, any candidate or any student who is actually bringing 90% in his engineering and another student bringing 75% in that particular stuff, and both get selected in Infosys at the same pay scale. So what's the difference between them? Because the education is same. So what's the difference?
It is education, but always remember, it's not only education.
So this means that it is not the essential part of a success.
It is an essential part of success, but it is not the only part of success, my friend.
What my friend said here, education is the key to success. But you have to find a door that you could fit in that key. You have to find that door. Education is a part, just a part of success. Just a small part. He said about the founder of Alibaba, he had to apply to many jobs.
And he was a faculty itself, he and his wife were teaching for a school.
I will complete my VTech in 1 year, then I will have to find my job. My education is complete, but now I have to.
He has given the example of Alibaba. Alibaba was a teacher. He was in a school, and he failed himself for a university exam for 3 times, and after that, the company he started before that for making websites for the other companies, and for that he uses the other software developers to develop his site for him. Not he himself never written a simple line of code himself. So his education was of literature. His education was not of computer science. His education was not of coding.
So if people were not educated, so how do you think those codes were written?
So if education was not
people
not,
learned them. You are getting a degree in computer science. Are you learning coding? Can you write a code right now? After 4 years of education, can you guarantee that you can write down a code for a site?
Exactly.
I know you personally. Uh-huh. You are a part of this educational system, and he is a guy who is interested in automobile. And he is right now pursuing CS engineering from SKL. This is the limitation of our educational system. You can learn what you like. If you are learning what you like, then an educated person will get success. But if you are not learning what you like, and education is of no use.
Alright, so I guess that's a personal choice. So whatsoever field you want to go on, let's not talk about me here. Yeah, that was really personal.
What we have seen here is that everybody is talking about the institutional education that we are getting here. What I would want to say that the work experience is also a type of education that we will get. No, just let me continue. Education is the acquisition of skills, of knowledge, of anything that you can improve yourself upon. Alright? Education helps us get the success. Alright? It is not a sure way to get the success. If I get a B.Tech, I will become a successful engineer. I will not become a successful engineer. I will become an engineer.
Just a second.
That's learning and experience.
And the word,
that means
word, we, okay,
in
word,
our
word experience.
Like educating ourselves. We will learn one or two small
learning,
things in
learning,
our
life.
Yes, we will learn and educate.
So that
learning
means
is a part of
I am
education.
Getting education my whole life, so I can't measure my success at any point.
No, you can measure your success by defining your achievements. Alright, if you have achieved what you have set your goals upon, you will call yourself a successful person only then.
But you are telling that acquiring of skills is also a type of education. I agree with you. But we will keep acquiring skills.
We will keep acquiring skills. Life is a continuous process.
Of learning, not of getting educated.
Yeah, that's what I am saying.
And my friends, one more thing is that work experience itself constitute of the word experience. Okay, the things we learn from the experiences of life is called work experience. It's not the education.
Excuse me. Here we are all talking about getting placed and all kind of stuff. I have a question. So my question is getting placed success?
Is we have to define
place.
What success is.
As per you only said that definition of success changed from person to person.
Exactly. So here we are discussing that if you are getting placed, you will be successful. So I believe that is not success. Success is what getting what we want. So getting what we want and educating in that way. So exactly, education does help in success. Education does help in success. But what kind of education you want, what kind of education you have to do for that, is that you have to choose.
Earlier also I have said that what kind of education you are saying. So I have also said that we are learning for the 17 years of our life to know in what direction we are going to work. And after that we suddenly switch to banking sector, suddenly switch to some other army sector. We are not learning martial arts over here.
Guys, could you have a look at the picture that is on the screen? So it says success ahead. So I would like to ask you all a question. Is the path that we are following right now, average college going student or average school going kid, right? Is the path that we are following right now the appropriate path that we get successful in the life or in the future? Just a sec. And I would like the audience to maintain the decorum, please. Respect the speaker who is speaking.
From that picture, I remember a poem that I studied in 7th and 8th class by Robert Frost. Its beginning was something like that, two roads lay straight ahead and I chose the lesser one. So you have to choose. You will, after education, you will have to choose which road you have to go on.
Guys, last 5 minutes to discuss your points. So if you want to express your views, just make a timeout sign and I'll be coming to you. So yes.
So as a conclusion, in my opinion, I would say that education part is plays a role in getting success, but it's not at all important or correlated with success. Okay, because I have also said in a discussion, what we learned, we never do that. We have learned mechanical engineering, but if we do not get, we think the way in what direction we can go. First, we will try the placements. Where if in case if I don't get any placement, I will go to the banking sector, that is of commerce section. After that, I will go to, if I don't get in any of that, I will do entrepreneurship. I will think of new ideas so that I can work and earn my livelihood. So that would be all, again of a management section, and these are all way apart from engineering.
So let's say according to you, education does not play any role in success, right?
According to, it's plays on definition. And for a common man, doing work for any superior is not at all success.
According to you,
the question is education is necessary, not a role.
So education is not necessary for success, according to you, huh? So why do you wake up 6 in the morning and come here every single morning?
And please, why do you say for learning?
What is the reason for that?
Please do not say learning, sorry. Please do not say to learn. Learning is a part of being
educated. You certainly don't come here. You people come here to get the degree. That's it.
My friend, I have a
friend.
Is it? I want to ask the audience, is it not so?
My friend, learning is not enough part of a...
I guess I have made my point very clear.
Yes, very good. But I told you that you have to express your views. And at the starting only I explained you that it's not a debate, it's a discussion. There's a vast difference between it. So I would like Mohit Soni to express his views.
After this discussion, what I feel is that education, primary education, is obviously very important for being successful. It's very, very important. And talking about higher education, everyone said that when you said that education is key to success, I agree with you, but that's not the only key to success. There is a master key called knowledge. It's the master key for success. You take education, knowledge. You grew up for knowledge, not education. You are here for knowledge, not for education. So what I think is that education is key to success, but knowledge is the master key to success.
To answer his question about why do we come to college, mostly 95% of the students who are here because of peer pressure and societal pressure to get a degree.
That would be a topic we would be discussing in the next group discussion around.
Okay.
So you cannot make that kind of judgment on
95%. Yes, I can.
You cannot.
There have been surveys.
There are many.
There have been many surveys. We are getting away from the discussion.
Respect this.
About education and success. Education can be helpful to certain people when what they want to achieve in life is parallel is what they are studying in their academics. But it is definitely not essential to be educated to get success. Thank
you. What makes you differ than what is knowledge and what is education? You are getting educated and then only you are knowing that what is knowledge.
The difference between knowledge and education is knowledge is what you want to learn. And education is what you are forced to learn.
Guys, sorry to interrupt, but you are forcing me to exempt you and I'm then taking only their views. So please. Yes.
At the end also, I will stick to my topic. Knowledge is a must for achieving success. Without knowledge, you won't be able to even cope up anything. You won't be able to stand in front of everyone. And you can't view your point in front of everyone.
I also
also think that apart from education, you need good communication skills and a way to interact with people that you can use your education from. That is,
I think that education is an essential part of getting success. It develops our critical thinking and it develops our minds, which is very important.
Well, we are being educated to gain knowledge. We are being sent to educational institutes to gain knowledge. Now it's upon you whether you want to gain knowledge or not. That's it.
You pass on the mic.
Okay, let's get to ourselves and think that what we want to be in our life, is engineering actually helping us out into it? And we'll get the answer by ourselves.
In conclusion, I would also like to say that primary education is a must thing. Primary education is the must thing, but to get success in life, we must have determination and luck and hard work. And hard work is the most important thing. And we take example like many of our Bollywood celebrities and our celebrities get kicked out from their school life. But right now they have achieved success in their life.
I believe everybody here feels success is earning money and is earning money, fulfilling their greeds. But my belief is success is at every walk of life. Getting here on time is success. To get here on time, we have to wake up early, dress up, and then come, whatever is our convenience. So I believe success is every point of at every point, and to achieve that, we need basic education. Basic education is necessary. So, yes, my friend.
Okay.